very good morning to one and all, and it's a wonderful platform where we are given to know our colleagues in India and what's happening. I think the scenario in India is pretty alarming, and it comes to the students. I think there's a lot of fear, that's fear of the unknown. So what I would suggest at this point in time is that just take the example of what happened last year. I mean, so we were all so apprehensive, and our school was a center, and suddenly there was a halt to all the exams. But we did get the results, you know. Children did get the results, and I don't think there were many cases where there were concerns with regards to the evaluation system that was suggested and done by the CBSE. So I think there has to be a level of faith, there has to be a level of trust in what's going to happen, and I think the best will happen. So even if the grade 12 exams don't happen, we did get some time, you know, this time. In fact, everybody got more time to conduct model exams, and we had in fact two rounds of a model exam with a pre-model exam. So we used a similar kind of scenario when it came to, you know, the grade 10 for internal promotions and things like that. So similar things could be worked out internally or as directed by the CBSE. So I don't think there should be only thing is because they are not aware, probably having sessions with the parents. So what we're doing here in Dubai, though the scenario is still under control, but we as the foreign schools, we go along with, the entire CBSE working model. So we are also not having exams. And grade 12, what we've done in our school is that we have started counseling sessions where, the children can, come one-to-one with the counselor, school counselor, and there are sessions given by the school counselor. We also having sessions with our parents, because there will be a lot of questions and queries by the parents. And I think even from India, we have, our co-sister schools where they are having a lot of webinars with regards to the questions that are being posed by, you know, some of the parents, and they get their answers through that. So, that's what we are doing at this point in time. But as a suggestion to all the parents and the students is, I think there has to be a level of trust, and there has to also be a more of positivity, because here a lot of emphasis by the local government is paid on the wellness and happiness of the students. So more than anything else, the marks and everything leave aside, because at this point in time, I happened to meet my student council, and you know what they were saying, that they were under so much of depression because they could not go out, they could not meet their friends until and unless, you know, then when we started the virtual classes, and we also had a lot of activities for them to, you know, virtually connect with their friends, and had some events and activities which could give them, you know, some kind of, happiness and a sense of competition and participation across the schools. Because when you're virtually connected, I think you can connect more at this point in time, because that's the only alternative. It cannot overrule the human element, but yes, there is connectivity. So I think this is what, led the children to be a little more happy. And when they said that they could see their friends and their teachers at least connect virtually, things started settling down. So I think they have to look at the positive side of it. And I think this is a time when they can spend quality time with their families, which also gives a lot of happiness. It gives a lot of, satisfaction. And probably, who knows, 2 years down the lane, we might think that, oh, that was a time when I could actually spend quality time. Now I'm back to the rat race. So I think there is always, it's about the attitude where we look into the positive things. What we've been always dreaming of, the digital platform, actually has become a reality today. Who knew that it's going to be an overnight reality? It just happened overnight. All this while we were, kind of struggling and trying to manage things digitally. And we were saying, oh, in between the classrooms and the lessons, we will probably have a digital content. But now you see everything is totally digital. So it just evolved. So things evolve, life evolves. And I think this is a passing phase. This will also pass by. And we should always look at some good things in life. That's what I believe in. Yeah. Thank you.